in this session, I'm going to show you a case with a percutaneous chimney EVAR for treatment of pararenal aneurysm. He was a quite young patient, 64 years old, with quite a lot of comorbidities, but mainly he had a very, very heavy COPD that was our anesthetist at the first time was not able for general anesthesia, but after a month period, he was getting quite better, and we decided to treat him. He was a very thin man, 55 kilograms, and he had a pararenal aneurysm of 52 millimeters with a rapid expansion the previous 6 months, and the suprarenal aorta was with a quite small diameter, and he has also narrow aortic bifurcation and narrow iliac arteries. These are the measurements, the preoperative CTAs. You can see them here. The diameters at the aortic bifurcation was less than 18 millimeters. Our treatment options for this pararenal aneurysm with a narrow suprarenal aorta, aortic bifurcation, and iliac arteries, we wanted a short duration of operations due to very severe COPD. To have a general anesthesia to be sure that our grafts will be placed in the right position. So we decided to do him with a percutaneous chimney EVAR with two renal arteries with a low profile endograft. We choose the Cordis endograft from the Ingraft endograft from Cordis and decided to do it in a percutaneous axis. This is the preoperative sizing, the preoperative planning with the optimal C-arm orientation for the aortic neck and the splanchnic vessels to catheterize. And these are the access points, all of them under ultrasonographic guidance as we used to do in the department. These were the plans for the left and the right renal arteries to be treated with big grafts at 5 millimeters, very small arteries, and the ingraft from Gordis, as you can see. And now I can show you a small video with this procedure. We puncture the femoral arteries under ultrasonographic guidance to be in the anterior portion of the artery and in the mid of that. And after that, we use two ProGlide devices for the main graft, which for this graft, the Cordis graft is just 14 French, the main graft, and just 11 French for the contralateral limb. So for the contralateral limb, we use just one ProGlide to close the artery. On the main graft, as I said, two ProGlide, as you can see here, the second ProGlide is inserted. These are the sheaths in the femoral, and then we proceeded with the catheterization under ultrasonography for two branchial arteries, putting five French sheaths on that, and using no ProGlide, but just manual compression after the end of the procedure, as just seven French ANLs from Cook were used for the catheterization and deployment of the renal stents. You can see here the first such sheath coming down from the left subclavian artery and the catheterization of the left renal artery, putting a rosin wire there and left it in place. Confirmation that we are in the right place, and then a second INL sheath coming, also seven French, coming from the right branchial artery down to the suprarenal aorta, and the catheterization of the right renal artery was done after that. The right kidney was quite in the pelvis, very low, and you see the angle there. The two Rosen wires in place, confirmation for the good position, and then the in-graft device coming from the right femoral artery. You can see here the angio to define the place of the superior mesenteric artery and opening up the aortic device with the sheath inside the renal arteries. You can see here a confirmation angio, the full opening of the device, and then ballooning of the stents and ballooning of the main device, and confirmation angio as well, confirming the good placement of the device. After that, we had to catheterize the contralateral limb, which is an 11 millimeter limb, and placement of the two iliac extension. I remind you that the Cordis device is a three-piece device. We know that we had a very narrow aortic bifurcation. So after the deployment of both iliac limbs and ballooning them, we noticed a quite narrowing at the aortic bifurcation, so we decided to place two balloon expandable bare metal stents in a kissing manner to be sure that we have no occlusion of one of the limbs in the follow-up period. You can see these two balloon expandable stents. That opening up the aortic bifurcation and the origin of the iliac arteries, and the confirmation angios to be sure that we were in place. At the very end of the angio, we can see a small type 1 endoleak. We ballooned the graft, but we decided to wait and see in this patient. We closed the per-closed devices, as you can see here, in the left one device and on the right side two devices, ProGlide devices with no problem on this patient. Maybe to the very good profile of this specific endograft. And after finishing the procedure, may I have the slides, please? The patient went back to the ward with no need of ICU. But on the next day, the first osteopath of the day, we noticed important hematomas on both arms and also in both femoral sides. The hematocrit fell, and there was a huge deterioration of APTT, INR, and PT in this patient. We treated him conservatively with a blood transfusion and trying to resolve the coagulation problems, and then he was stabilized and we performed the CTA in the second postoperative day. And we see, as you can see in this CTA, we had a quite big type 1 endoleak in this side, but also huge hematomas on both arms and legs. So because of the coagulopathy, we decided to wait and see for 1 month and perform a second CTA after a month. So we discharged the patient home the fifth postoperative day and scheduled a second CTA in the 30th day. And fortunately, in the 30-day CTA, both renal arteries were well perfused. There was no endoleak anymore, and everything was seemed good and in place. And you can see here, no gutter endoleak anymore, no type 1 endoleak anymore, very good patent sense, and then the patient was normal about coagulation and under dual antiplatelet therapy. And we wait to have him in the next week and see the 6-month follow-up of this patient. Thank you very much for your attention.
Thank you, Miltos, for the next presentation.